Good afternoon, folks. Today we're going to talk about the Kuns Park area. Way back 110 years ago, Henry Kuns and his wife decided that they would donate this block here to the city for a public park. And we call it Kuns Park, but at the time, they called it Eline Park because that was Mrs. Kuntz's middle name. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the park itself and how it got started, and then some of the houses that are built around it. Well, according to some of the photos we have and some of the written descriptions, the park was to have, and apparently did have, a fountain in the middle of it. It had several walkways around, and one photo actually shows tennis court. Another interesting thing, one article, and I'll quote from it, it says, "No houses are allowed in this tract to cost less than $1,500. Well, nowadays we wouldn't have any trouble with that, but maybe some people did then. Two of the first houses on the extreme ends of the block on Magnolia are the first two that were built. And the first one was by Henry Kuntz, and the other one is for J.M. Johnson, who was his son-in-law. So as time went on, more houses sprung up around the periphery of the park. Among the other early homes were the Overholzer home, which is back here on the corner of Park and Fifth. Samuel Overholzer, his father was Samuel Ashton Overholzer, who was one of the founders of Lordsburg College. The son, he was the manager, some say the owner, of Lordsburg Lumber Company, which was down on E and First Streets and was eventually replaced by a packing house in 1920. Some of the next ones were the Calkins Perrin House, which was also built in 1912. Glennis Perrin was a well-known and a person of long duration in the school system as a teacher, mostly at Lincoln School. And then you have the Gerward Bowers residence, which was built in 1914. Gerward himself was an orange grower, but he was also at one point the mayor of La Verne, and he was also the principal of Bonita Union High School. Then later on, one of the more well-known and longer lasting residents was Eugene and Ora Lee Bauer. Wanted to give you a little background about Henry Kuntz. Everybody hears about him, but they don't realize that he was not a person who'd lived here a long time prior to this time of having Kuntz Park. His parents lived here. They moved here several years before he did. Both of them were quite elderly, and they began to suffer the ravages of old age, and so he actually moved to Lordsburg to help them out, because he was the type of person who would get involved in the community and other organizations. A lot of his property, including I'm sure this property here, was what he had inherited from his parents. One of the most famous things is that he donated the building and the property for the David and Margaret home in 1910. The other thing I think we'll throw in here is that quite often people think that he was a member of the Church of the Brethren or the German Baptist Brethren, but he actually was a Methodist. And so that's, you know, why he donated the David and Margaret home property and the building to the Methodist Women's Society. As kind of a wrap up, I think I'd like to mention the five homes that we've already referred to that possess bronze markers. They're recognized by the City of La Verne and the Historical Society for various things. And so the bronze markers have some of the highlights of the home listed on them. And I would say that if you wanted to take a tour of these, as far as looking at the outside of them, I would suggest that you would start at the corner on Magnolia and Bonita. To help and guide you, our website has all the bronze markers listed with their addresses and the name that they're referred to. And of course, as always, you can call or write or email or whatever to the Historical Society and ask questions, because we're always wanting to make sure that people understand our history and help us to spread the word that we're here, and our history will always be available to people.